Atlantic Broadband Cable, in cooperation with the South Union Township Supervisors, presents the South Union Township Sports Network. Today, via tape delay from James Weir Stadium in Belle Vernon, it's high school boys soccer action as the Laurel Highlands Mustangs take on the Belle Vernon Leopards. Hi, everybody. I'm Brian Morozak with Jerry Dupay, and we welcome you aboard for tonight's boys soccer game. South Union Township Sports Network coverage is brought to you as a joint cooperative venture featuring Township Supervisors Bob Schiffbauer, Rick Vernon, and Jason Scott, Atlantic Broadband Cable, Armstrong Cable, and our friends at CUTV, including Gary Smith. Again, I'm Brian Morozak with Jerry Dupay, and we'll be back with the lineups for both teams after these messages.
Esophageal reflux affects 20% of Americans and can lead to heartburn, regurgitation, chest pain, and difficulty swallowing. Reflux is caused by stomach contents passing a faulty valve and entering the esophagus. Ulcers and precancerous tissue can then form. Doctors Ruthart, Calabrese, Stokes, and Ballou offer the latest testing and treatment for reflux disease. SWGI, specialists in digestive health.
At what point did everything change? When did service get taken out of service industries? It's too bad, because people are busy these days, at life, at work, at play. When it comes to your hard-earned money, you want service, real service, from a person you know and a face you trust. At a bank where changing with the times doesn't mean leaving people behind. We're proud to be a part of your community. We're United Bank, at your service.
Creditors calling you day and night? Your debt overwhelms you? Although you may feel that you're in a hopeless situation, Zebley Mahalov & White can help. We're a full-service local bankruptcy firm that knows what a difficult time this is and what to do to help you get a fresh start. Call Zebley Mahalov & White today for a free consultation. Your hometown bankruptcy firm. Call us today.
Don't borrow more money until you talk to Zebley Mahalov & White.
We're back here at James Weir Stadium for the conference opener, Section 3 AAA play. The Belle Vernon Leopards hosting the Laurel Highlands Mustangs. I'm now going to turn it over to our public address announcer, Scott Cardilla, for tonight's starting lineups.
Welcome to Belle Vernon area. Starting for the Laurel Highlands Mustangs. Number 2, Captain Tim Mahalko. Captain, number 3, Jared Davis. Number 6, Jacob Campbell. Number 8, Braden Steele. Number 11, Colby Davis. Number 21, Dawn Martella. Number 25, Eli Mitchell. Number 26, Todd Brown. 28, Connor Rock. Number 33, Dylan Seaman. Number 37, Captain Timothy Lucas. Number 11, Captain Senior Number 12, Captain Senior Jared Guest. Number 23, Senior Tyler Salega. Number 24, Senior in goal, Tommy Rodriguez. Number 10, Junior Jackson Gap. Number 24, Junior Marky Lovett. Number 28, Junior Peyton Colvin. Number 3, Sophomore Aaron Brown. Number 8, Sophomore Martello Apodiakis. Number 14, Sophomore Hunter Martin. Please stand. Raise your intestine to the side of the scoreboard for the national anthem.
We'll be back with the start of tonight's match. Bell Vernon hosting Laurel Highlands High School soccer here on the South Union Township Sports Network.
Tonight's soccer game is being brought to you in part by Dr. Michael Lemontowski and Surgical Associates, 10 Highland Park Drive here in Uniontown. They can be reached at 724-439-6340. Good luck to the area teams from Dr. Michael Lemontowski.
Chesler's Furniture at 601 Pittsburgh Street, Uniontown has been in business since 1950 and has a wide variety of furniture for all of your needs. At Chesler's, they have a wide assortment of living room recliners, kitchen sets, bedroom mattresses, and accessories that can decorate your home for years to come. Choose from many companies including Lazy Boy, Best, King Hickory, Hammery, Lancer, Wildwood, Von Bassett, and White Dove. Chesler's also services what they sell. Stop into Chesler's Fine Furniture, Route 51 north of Uniontown, and see Kim, Christy, Ted, and Rich. They'll be happy to help you with all of your needs. Chesler's Furniture, where customers send their friends.
We're back here at James Weir Stadium, conference opener for the Bell Vernon Leopards and the Laurel Highlands Mustangs. The Mustangs 3-1-1 overall. Bell Vernon 2-1 overall. The Mustangs have put up some big goal totals early on in the season, including a 9-1 win over Brownsville and a 9-0 win over McKeesport. The Mustangs a 2-2 draw with Elizabeth Forward last time out. Bell Vernon a 2-1 record. They had a 10-1 win over Steel Valley, a 1-0 win over Connellsville. They also lost 4-1 against Cannon Mack last time out. Bell Vernon moving left to right on your television screens here in the first half. The Mustangs and the Bell Vernon Leopards. The Leopards in the all-white home kits, dark green numbers trimmed in gold. The Mustangs in their away red shirts, blue shorts, and white numbers. The Mustangs on the attack early on with Colby Davis. But Davis's attack shut down early on there by Jarrett Guess, and Bell Vernon in transition looking for a headman pass to Markello Apodiakis. And the ball played into the far corner. Jarrett Davis battling there for Laurel Highlands, but Apodiakis wins the ball for Bell Vernon, trying to play top of the box. Chipped around. Leopards try to stay with it. Played back here from 30 yards out. Blocked down by Dylan Seaman on the shot attempt there from Peyton Kolditz of Bell Vernon. And the Mustangs able to play it back to center on the far side. That's Dom Margiello. Off to Connor Rapp. Rapp a little touch back ahead. Down to Margiello again in the far corner. Last touch going out off of Jarrett Guess of Bell Vernon. One of three Guesses in the Bell Vernon lineup here today. Jarrett, a senior. Cameron, a freshman. He was actually the Bell Vernon football kicker. And the third Guess is Jackson, a junior. Rolled a corner kick for Laurel Highlands on the far side. It'll be Connor Rapp to take the corner. 90 seconds in here at James Weir Stadium. Brian Morozak alongside Jerry Dupay. And Rapp puts it into the mixer on the near post. Leopards chip it out to the top of the 18. And Brown partially fanned on the shot. He gets back to Tommy Rodriguez. Is able to scoop it up. And the Leopards will look to reset from their own end. Rodriguez also a pretty good hoopster as well. Played on the Bell Vernon basketball team this past season. Sends it back off to center. Headed there by Braden Steele of Laurel Highlands, trying to play it up to Margiello on the far side. Leopards, though, gain control, and they'll try to chase it down to Aaron Brown. But it goes all the way back to the Mustang keeper, Jacob Campbell. And Campbell fires it out to Dylan Seaman. Campbell, a pair of clean sheets already on the season for Laurel Highlands, and a little pressure there again from the Leopards. Won there by Tyler Saliga looking to center. And goes into the side of the goal for a Mustang goal kick. We played 2.5 minutes here at James Weir Stadium on the gold turf. Still scoreless between Laurel Highlands and Bell Vernon. John Karatkis, the head coach of the Bell Vernon Leopards. Jerry Rogers, the head coach of the Laurel Highlands Mustangs. Leopards back on the attack. Evan Brown. Playing it back, and the shot from 20 just goes wide. Good look there for Markello Apodiakis. Ball was last touched by the Mustangs. Going out will be a corner kick for the Leopards. here in the Laurel Highlands zone to be taken by Jackson Guess, the junior midfielder. Let's bring four players over here on the near side and set up a dummy wall as they now break it. And Guess will put it into the box, headed out in front, and Guess will get another opportunity to reload here from the near side. Chipped out there by Todd Brown. Mustangs try to set up the attack coming back. Jackson Guess able to regain. He'll play it back to his back line to Mark Lovett. Lovett forward again to Jarrett Guess. Chipped high and headed forward into the corner again to Aaron Brown. Brown trying to work on the Mustangs. Timmy Mahalko centers. No one home. Played back to the top of the 18. And a shot in for the opening goal of the night from Hunter Martin. So Hunter Martin of Belle Vernon scoring here at the 36-01 mark of the first half to give the Leopards an early 1-0 lead here on the South Union Township Sports Network. So Belle Vernon controlling possession and getting the opening goal from Hunter Martin. 3:59 in. There's a mistake from Todd Brown. Apodiakis is on it. Look out. Here's Marco Apodiakis in the far corner for Belle Vernon. Apodiakis staying with it. Broken up there by Brown. And Brown will look to clear up to Colby Davis. Davis, 8 goals already on the young season for the Mustangs. Unable to get past the Leopards' back line. And the Leps now reset from their own zone. Mark Lovett on the near line. Pressured there by Timmy Lucas. Might have been a handball there on Lucas. It'll be a free kick here for Belle Vernon. Quickly played forward there by Jared Guess up to Jackson Guess. Looked to play it into the box off of Davis's body. Jarrett now a little header there. Dylan Seaman comes over to help out for the Mustangs, but Laurel Highlands unable to clear. A lot of pressure out of the Leps here early on. Has paid dividends with an early Hunter Martin goal. Ball out of play here on the near side. Off of Laurel Highlands and out. But to the right of the flag for quick throw-in. Going to Tyler Saliga. Saliga getting some help there with Aaron Brown. And the Leps misplay it. Over on the near touchline. The Mustangs fire it in with Eli Mitchell. Trying to send it up to Timmy Lucas. Mark Lovett there for Belle Vernon. Lucas trying to win the ball, and he does, away from Lovett. Chipped forward to Colby Davis. The play rolled offsides. Might have been Margella on the far side. Coming across early for the Mustangs. Still 1-0, Belle Vernon over Laurel Highlands. We played about 6 minutes of soccer here in the South Union Township Sports Network. Leps played back into the Mustang zone off of Mahalko's head and out of play. Aaron Brown to take this throw in for Belle Vernon. Brown's side of the box to Apodiakis, back to Brown. Brown now inside the 18, looking for the cross. Might have went off of Jared Davison out. Ruling is actually off of Brown and out, so it will be a Laurel Highlands goal kick. Was not deflected there by Davis. Mustangs will take that, and they'll gain possession. Jacob Campbell goes high to center. A little scrum for it. Eli Mitchell there for Laurel Highlands. Chipped to Seaman, back to Mitchell on the give and go. Mitchell down the near touchline. Eli Mitchell on it, but broken up from behind by Aaron Brown. We'll stay with the Mustangs. Eli Mitchell again to reload. Into Dylan Seaman, edge of the box, back to Brown again. Brown crosses, goes all the way through. Connor Rapp trying to track it down there for Laurel Highlands. A reset from the far corner, a little pressure again from the left. Rapp able to keep it alive. Double team trying to fight it off and get back into the box. But solid defense on the Leopards' side as they play it back to Jackson Guess and out of their own zone. Forward up to Tyler Saliga. Saliga from midfield, a little pressure coming from behind. Saliga staying on it, getting help off to his right to Aaron Brown. Brown back up to Saliga, wasn't home, and Mahalko picks off the errant pass for Laurel Highlands. A little miscommunication, though, between Mahalko and Eli Mitchell. Out of bounds off the Mustangs and outs. And Brown will send it back into Jackson Guess. Guess, though, turns it over. Brown back on it. Check that Eli Mitchell back on it. He'll play it back to Jarrett Davis on the Laurel Highlands back line. Off to Braden Steele on the far side. We've played 8 minutes, still a 1-0 lead for Bell Vernon over Laurel Highlands. Steele looking for Margiela, goes all the way through and back to Jackson Guess. Reset again, looking for Aaron Brown. Through Brown, up to Saliga. Saliga, a little touch back up to Brown. Davis trying to defend there for Laurel Highlands. Brown staying with it as a triangle of Mustangs around. Brown trying to fight it off. Crosses out in front. And the save made there by the Mustang keeper, Jacob Campbell. So Campbell seeing some action early on. Mustangs trying to generate some offense on the other side. Laurel Highlands is yet to have a true shot on goal. As Margiela has it. Picked off on the far side. Leopards try to break back. A little touch there from Seaman off of Margiela's body. Forward to Connor Rapp. Pressured there by Peyton Kolditz. Ball sent into the air where it's won there by Dylan Seaman. Seaman a little touch back again to Brown. Forward there to Eli Mitchell. Mitchell a little chip to Dylan Seaman off to his left as the Mustangs try to set up something here in the Leopards zone. Seaman goes crossfield far side. Broken up by Bell Vernon. Knocked down by Hunter Martin. Played on the far side. Leopards try to take it back up with Evan Brown. Brown's run short-lived as Braden Steele comes over for Laurel Highlands to slow it down, but the Leps keep possession again. Here's a Podiak is loose. Shot from 25. Goes wide on the near side. And a goal kick here for Laurel Highlands. As Jacob Campbell calls for a new ball. And the Leps will make a couple of changes. Brandon Fort, number 29, will check into the game along with number 4, Logan Perez. So Fort and Perez seeing their first action, both juniors. Laurel Highlands has yet to make a change so far. Here's Mahalko from his own back line, broken up there by Fort. Touch back to Jackson Guess, over to Podiakis. Podiakis, a sniper from up top. Shown some range early on. A little scrum there. Hunter Martin already has a goal tonight. And the Leopards have done a nice job to control the possession here in the opening 10 minutes. Keeping it alive again in the Laurel Highlands zone. The Leopards entering play this week in the WPIL top 10 at number 9 with a 2-1 record. There's another long shot from about 32 yards out taken there by Hunter Martin. Scooped up by Jacob Campbell. And the offense on the Laurel Highlands side has been pretty much non-existent so far. Mustangs trying to find Timmy Lucas and able to get through that left back line. Jackson Guess staying with it for Bell Vernon. Off to his left to Martin, up to a Podiakis. Look out, a Podiakis from 24 yards just going wide here on the near side. A Podiakis showing plenty of range. Markello Opodiak is a sophomore. His brother also on the roster. He'll see some bench time. Nico Opodiakis also has a bright future with his Leopards soccer program. Goal kick here for Jacob Campbell. Campbell playing it back to center. Looking there for Connor Rapp. Won again by Jackson Guess. Guess back to Brandon Fort. Fort from the near touchline. Back to Guess again. Guess trying to reset. A little pressure there from Dylan Seaman. But Guess keeps the ball alive. Plays it off to his left to Mark Lovett. Forward again to a Podiakis. Podiakis dancing off to Ford again. Near side touch Jackson Guess. On the back line again to Peyton Kolditz. Kolditz goes crossfield on the far side. Leps keep it alive. That's Brennan Morgan. Pressured, lost the ball. Saved though by Peyton Kolditz. He tries to play it forward. Mustangs get a touch, but unable to set any kind of a rush up here on the near side. Seaman will look to attack again forward to Eli Mitchell. Up to Timmy Lucas. Lucas looking forward for Colby Davis. Never got his way. Now Laurel Highlands will try to attack here with Eli Mitchell near corner. Mitchell on the cross, headed out in front, but blocked down by a Leopards defender. Colby Davis got his head on the ball, but it never got back to Tommy Rodriguez in goal. Now a whistle here. Infraction against the Laurel Highlands side. Free kick for Bell Vernon. They'll go quickly. Apodiakis staying with it. Gets around Brown, trying to get around Steele. Apodiakis top of the box. Brown coming back and breaking up the attack. Steele will send it up to Margella on the far line. Margella slips on the cut, goes down, ball out of bounds off of Laurel Highlands. Quick throw taken on the far side by the Lemps. Fired in to Hunter Martin. Touchdown looking for Apodiakis. Apodiakis plays it in front of the far sidelines. Off to his right to Jackson Guess. Guess plays it back to his right to Hunter Martin. Martin top of the box, trying to come free, but Eli Mitchell on the clear there for Laurel Highlands. Goes through Lucas on the back line again to Mark Lovett. Lovett gets a little help there from Peyton Kolditz. Chipped forward again, up to Jackson Guess. Defended well there by Todd Brown. Jackson Guess again looks to reset here on the Leopard side. Look to chip down to Ford. Broken up there by Eli Mitchell. Back onto the foot of Dylan Seaman. Seaman back to Brown. He'll chip ahead forward to Davis. Laurel Highlands trying to set it up. Margella loose on the far side. Never got his way. Broken up by Jared Guess. Laurel Highlands will again try to reset from the midfield. Brown off to his left to Dylan Seaman. Seaman back through center. Touches down on the far side of Margella. Margella, though, loses control. Three Leopards around, and they'll clear it down the far line. Will stay in play momentarily before it's touched off of Jackson Guess and out. And Laurel Highlands will make a quick change. Going to Alec McLay off the bench. First time we've seen McLay. McLay, two goals and an assist on this young season. Has been very productive off the Mustang bench. He'll check in for Margella. Mustangs send it in to Todd Brown. And Mihalko will go high on the far side as Davis looks to track it down. Again, last touched by Bell Vernon. And McLay will have an opportunity here on the throw-in. McLay will lob it into the box. Colby Davis is there off of his body, looks to regain. Leopards look to clear. Foul here in the box on Laurel Highlands. Trip call there on Davis. And a free kick here for Bell Vernon. So we played 15 minutes of soccer. Bell Vernon leading Laurel Highlands 1-0 on a Hunter Martin goal at the 36:01 mark of the first half. Leps again played back to center. Steele trying to track it down. Jackson Guess with a head of steam. A little collision there on the far side. Leps now go back to their bench. Aaron Brown back in. And Cameron Guess will see his first action. Cameron, only a freshman, has had some double duty during the fall sports season. On Friday nights, he's been the Bell Vernon Leopards football kicker as well and has done a fine job so far this season on the football field as well. Low shot there, scooped up by Jacob Campbell. So Campbell staying busy. Only one has gotten past him so far. He'll play it back to center, sent along by Timmy Lucas, but right back to Mark Lovett. A little touch there to Fort. Fort, but knocked down by Laurel Highlands' Dylan Seaman. He'll play back to Timmy Mihalko. Mihalko back down the near touchline, looking there for Eli Mitchell. Fort again, a nice breakup there for the Leopards. Will send it out of play. Our match officials here today, Jimmy Pride and Jan Johnston. Doing a fine job here in the first half. Another whistle and an infraction here against the Leopards. Free kick for the Mustangs. Jared Davis will put it down. Jared sends it ahead. Leopards win it back just momentarily before Todd Brown looks to play it forward to Eli Mitchell. Ford is there, but Mitchell's going to continue to battle. Mitchell trying to keep it in bounds here on the near side. Fort knocks it out. Laurel Highlands throw in to be taken by Dylan Seaman. Seaman into Eli Mitchell. Back to Seaman again. Seaman, nice little dance around Fort, stays with it. Seaman off to his right. Back to Eli Mitchell at side of the box. Mitchell looking to cross. Loose out in front. Laurel Highlands unable to deflect it home. Still loose near post. Ball goes out of play. So Laurel Highlands all kind of action in front of the Leopards kicker, or the Leopards keeper, Tommy Rodriguez. Laurel Highlands unable to send one past Tommy as the ball behind the victory bell. Rodriguez will track it down. It'll be a goal kick here for the Leopards. Looks like Cameron Guest will take it. And Cameron showing a nice foot there, playing it back into the Laurel Highlands zone. Our Podiakas is on it. Nice little chip ahead on the far side to Aaron Brown. Brown trying to get around, steal, ball loose, scooped up there by Jacob Campbell. Again, the Leps bringing the pressure. Campbell plays it back to center. Colby Davis there for Laurel Highlands. Might have been a foul there from behind on Cameron Guest. Got Davis on the shoulder. Free kick for the Mustangs. Braden Steele will put it down from about 40 yards out. Steele a little touch forward. There to Todd Brown off to his left to Seaman. Give and go, trying to send it back to Brown. Broken up again by the Leps. Lucas, though, gets back on it for Laurel Highlands. Resets to Seaman. Off to his right again to Brown. And off to Steele. Steele far touchline. Sends it into the box. Never got in the direction of Colby Davis. Broken up by Jarrett Guess of Bell Vernon. Be another Laurel Highlands throw, and almost midway through this first half, Mustangs still trailing 1-0. Sent in through Lucas over to Seaman, whose shot just goes wide on the far side. Dylan Seaman with a nice effort there for Laurel Highlands. Leps go back to their bench. Evan Brown back into the game, number 18. Now replace Aaron Brown, number 3. Now check that. It looks like Aaron's going to stay here. It was actually 29, Brandon Fort, that exited the game for the Leopards. Our Highlands, a little touch forward. They're looking for McAlay. Broken up again by Bell Vernon, and they have numbers coming back. A Podiakas off to Jackson Guess. Guess playing it forward. Podiak is again top of the box. Broken up there by the Mustangs. And Jared Davis will pull it over to Braden Steele. Steele trying to keep it in play. He does. And Steele will send it off of Evan Brown and out for Laurel Highlands throwing. Steele forward again to McAlay. Goes through McAlay. Down the far side to Connor Rapp. Rapp back into the Leopard zone. Off to Timmy Lucas. Try to send it back to Rapp. Broken up. Right on the foot of Dylan Seaman. Seaman sending it forward, headed back there by Evan Brown. Picked up by Hunter Martin. And Martin sends it down the far line. Podiakas picks it up there for Bell Vernon. Forward to Jackson Guess. Guess on the chip, back in Podiakas' direction. Podiakas on the far side. Pressure there by Steele, and Steele doing a nice job for Laurel Highlands to find the ball and send it out of his own zone. Here's Steele on his horse. Steele down the far side, tried to play it off to his left to Rapp, never got his way. Here's a Podiakas, another opportunity coming back for Bell Vernon. A Podiakas off to his left, cross, picked up by Jacob Campbell. Campbell intercepting the cross. The score remains 1-0 Leps, 18:46 left here in the first half. Leps staying strong on the attack, Jackson Guess again. Playing it back to Evan Brown, and now Jackson Guess. Pressure there from Seaman. Guess goes down, and a foul on Dylan Seaman. No, they're going to call this on Guess. Big break there for the Mustangs. Infraction going on Jackson Guess, not Dylan Seaman. Laurel Highlands will take it, and they'll regain possession from their own zone. Todd Brown. Brown back to center, off the body of Eli Mitchell. A little pressure there from behind from Aaron Brown. Off to Seaman. To his right to Connor Rapp. Rapp a little fake forward to Seaman again. Seaman dances off to his right. Pressure there by Hunter Martin. To his left, a Connor Rapp, intercepted by Jackson Guess. Guess off to Apodiakis, and now Guess again. Mustangs throwing the body in a little bit there. Connor Rapp, a little push there on Jackson Guess. And Rapp called for the infraction. Free kick for Belle Vernon from their own zone. Nice night for high school soccer. Game time temperature in the low 70s here in mid-September. Cam Guess sends it top of the 18. Perez trying to knock it down. Perez on the cross, broken up by Timmy Mihalko, and played forward to Timmy Lucas. Lucas a little header. No one home, though, and on the Belle Vernon back line, it's Mark Lovett sending it ahead. Touch by Fort. Jackson Guess plays it back. From his own zone, Evan Brown leads the attack. On the far wing, nice little drop back. Loose top of the box. Look out, Jackson Guess, low shot. Saved there by the Mustang keeper, Jacob Campbell. But the Leopards working with plenty of open space once again in the Laurel Highlands zone. Took a diving save from Campbell to keep this game at 1-0. Be another corner kick here for Belle Vernon. We'll take a quick timeout here on the South Union Township Sports Network.
Good luck to the Mustangs from the South Union Township Supervisors, Rick Vernon, Jason Scott, and Robert Schiffbauer.
Colon cancer is the second leading cause of cancer deaths. Signs include abdominal pain and rectal bleeding. Colon cancer develops from a degenerating benign growth or polyp. Doctors performing colonoscopy are able to remove precancerous polyps, thus preventing colon cancer. This saves lives, and the American Cancer Society now recommends that everyone have a colonoscopy every 10 years, beginning at age 50. Doctors Ruth Hart, Calabrese, Stokes, and Ballou offer the latest diagnostic testing, SWGI, specialists in digestive health.
Belle Vernon corner kick as we come back. Nico Apodiakis will put it down. The freshman sends it into the box. Rapp trying to knock it out again. Loose top of the 18, but going high there is Hunter Martin. Martin, a couple of opportunities to get a first half brace here. Already had a goal at the 36:01 mark of the first half. He's been very active in the Leps attack. Lucas battling there with Fort. Seaman also in the mix. And a push call there on the Leopards side. Nico Apodiakis might have gotten Seaman there from behind. And Jared Davis will put the ball down for the Laurel Highlands free kick. Davis touches it off to his right to Todd Brown. Brown on the far line. Four there from Argella. Argella trying to stay with it. Pressured by Brennan Morgan. Ball out of bounds off of Laurel Highlands and out, and Morgan will trigger it back in here for the Leps. Brennan Morgan, number 11, senior co-captain. Wearing one of the armbands tonight. On the left side. Leps trying to set up an attack. Mustangs knock it down. Seaman back on. Battle there with Hunter Martin. Those two still go at it. Martin wins it for now. Send it off to his left. Broken up there by Laurel Highlands' Braden Steele. McLay unable to track it down. Ball goes back to Tommy Rodriguez, who plays it back to center. Headed there by Markello Apodiakis. Off to Aaron Brown. Both Nico and Markello, the Apodiakis brothers, both on the field for Belle Vernon, but it's Eli Mitchell winning it right now for Laurel Highlands. Mitchell trying to send it up to Colby Davis, never got his way. Again, cleared by the Leps. Forward looking for Tyler Saliga. Leps knock it down, and there's Markello Apodiakis loose! Just scooped up by Jacob Campbell. The Apodiakis bearing down on him. Campbell, top of his own box, sends it away. Up to Colby Davis, touch forward. Davis will try to track it down. Rodriguez says thank you very much on the scoop up. And he'll roll it out on the near side to Cameron Guess. Play down the near touchline. Mahalko there for Laurel Highlands. Off of Seaman. And Eli Mitchell trying to keep it in play for Laurel Highlands does so, playing it off of Peyton Kolditz and out. Mustangs go back to their bench. Into the game for Laurel Highlands, number 30, Jamison Seabart. And number 10, Dylan Rice. Rice saw plenty of varsity action as a sophomore. This is Siebert's first year on the varsity squad. Headed there by Todd Brown, off to Dylan Seaman. Now Connor Rapp. Jerry Frater also into the game for Laurel Highlands. Had a little touch. And Seaman goes cross field far side. And knocked out a play by Evan Brown of Bell Vernon. So the Mustangs, another throw-in. There hasn't been too much offense in the Bell Vernon zone. Leps controlling the possession so far. Dylan Rice will trigger this ball in for Laurel Highlands. Rice over the head of Seaman, touched there by McLay, never got to Colby Davis. Mustangs trying to keep possession here outside the box. McLay's shot blocked down. Seaman back on it. Seaman from about 25 yards out. Had deflected out of bounds. Will be a corner here for Laurel Highlands. And Connor Rapp will take this corner. And Rapp puts it into the box. Leps able to clear momentarily. Mustangs reset on the near side. Frater playing it back to Mahalko. And Bell Vernon back to center. Here's Tyler Salig on the rush. Two on two coming back. Has Apodiakis to his left. Sends it his way. Markello Apodiakis in open space. Apodiakis gets around Jared Davis. Apodiakis' shot off the near post and in. Markello Apodiakis makes it 2-0 Bell Vernon here at the 11:27 mark of the first half. And what an athletic effort there from Apodiakis and the Leps. We'll take a quick timeout here on the South Union Township Sports Network. Markello Apodiakis making it 2-0 Bell Vernon over Laurel Highlands. And the 11:27 mark of the first half. And Laurel Highlands now in an early hole. And we'll see if they get a little more aggressive, trying to create some opportunities for themselves. Now down two in this conference opener. Near side, Tyler Saliga. He's done a nice job to create so far tonight. Saliga on the cross. Go out of play for Laurel Highlands' goal kick. So we've seen a competitive game so far tonight. The two goals scored on the Bell Vernon side from Hunter Martin and Markello Apodiakis. That's been the difference. You really couldn't fault Jacob Campbell for either of those two goals. Seaman battling there with Tyler Saliga. Mustangs win it for now. Connor Rapp fighting off a double team. Touching it ahead to McAlay. Alex McAlay back to Seaman. Far side to Rapp again. Connor Rapp trying to dance around a triangle of lefts. Off to Seaman. Back to Rapp on the give and go. Rapp off to his left looking for open space. Forward to Frater. And now Rapp again. Rapp on the cross. Went off the head of Aaron Brown. Back again to Rapp. Off to Mihalko. Mihalko from his own zone. Timmy Mihalko coming forward. Touched by Frater looking to reset. Trying to get it up to Colby Davis, who played back to center. Look out. Here's Tyler Saliga again. Broken up this time by Jared Davis. Fires it back to Dylan Seaman. Off to his left to Mihalko, and they weren't on the same page. Out of bounds, off to Bell Vernon. Leps go back to their bench. Josh Martin in the game for the first time. And Brendan Fort will re-enter. We'll take a quick timeout here on the South Union Township Sports Network.
Just sit right down and you hear a tale of a fateful call. You better pay those bills right now or you take a mighty fall. He really didn't know what to do, so he turned to those who did. Zeppeli, Mahalov, and White, your bankruptcy crew. Your bankruptcy crew. So no matter how deep in debt you are, if your back's against the wall, Zeppeli, Mahalov, and White, just give them a call.
Back underway, Leps with the ball. Up 2-0. 9 minutes left here in the first half. Saliga, a little touch ahead to Jackson Guess. Back to Saliga again. Saliga's a little lob forward off the head there of Aaron Brown. Mustangs try to play it back to Colby Davis. And Davis's opportunities have been few and far between. One of the leading goal scorers in the WPIL in this young season with 8 already. He'll try to get it his way as Colby Davis, the sophomore, trying to track it down. A little contact. We're going to play on no. Infraction called here on Davis. Body contact with the junior defender, Mark Lovett. And a free kick here for the Leps. The Mustangs just haven't been able to get their striker, Davis, free in open space. It's been the difference tonight. Here's Jackson Guest coming back for the Leps. Broken up there by Mihalko. Timmy Mihalko doing a nice job there for Laurel Highlands. Forward to Colby Davis, try to play it back in Mihalko's direction. And Mihalko says, I'm going to try to lead the rush here. The Mustang defender had a knocked out of play there by Peyton Kolditz. Now Mihalko centering it top of the box to McLay. A little collision there. Ball comes loose. And the keeper, Tommy Rodriguez, able to play it back to center. A little battle there between Todd Brown going at it with Tyler Saliga. This foul going Bell Vernon. Things getting a little chippy here in the final 8 minutes of the first half. Jared Davis plays it top of the box. Looking for Colby. Headed there by Connor Rapp and scooped up by Tommy Rodriguez with Alex McAlay bearing down. Rodriguez back to center. Chipped there by Todd Brown. The Leps keep possession. Touch there from Kolditz. Forward on the near side, Aaron Brown. Back to Saliga and now Brown again. Brown knocks it down. Quinton dances way, though, around Frater, and Frater plays it down the near touchline forward to Colby Davis. Davis back to center. A little collision and a foul here on Bell Vernon. Mustangs try to go quick. Dylan Seaman trying to send it down. The ball not whistled in play. That will allow the Leps to get some reinforcements back defensively. With 6:10 left before halftime. Jared Davis for midfield. Davis getting top of the 18. Mustangs trying to create some action here. Dylan Seaman shouldered off the ball there by Peyton Kolditz. Seaman, though, trying to stay with it. Seaman needs some help. Send it off to Todd Brown. Now Seaman again. Going low and forward there to McAlay. Touch back to Connor Rapp. Rapp off to his right. Over to Seaman, and now Rapp again. Trying to fight off Aaron Brown. Brown, though, wins the ball. Leps try to clear. Mustangs keep it in. Todd Brown off to Rapp again. Here's Connor Rapp dancing forward. Up to Colby Davis. Davis's long shot just going wide here on the near side. Might have been the first shot on goal. Actually, not on goal, but at least shot generated there by Davis. Who, again, hasn't had too many open opportunities. Most of the balls thrown in Rodriguez's direction have been easy scoop-ups. Under 5 minutes now left here in the first half. Mustangs again played back to center. That time scooped up by Jacob Campbell. Norah Highlands out of their own zone. Connor Rapp in traffic. Loses the ball there to Jackson Guess. Guess plays it off to his back line there to Brennan Morgan. Morgan pressure there by Alex McAlay. Mustangs keep possession here momentarily. That's Jamison Seabart playing it down the far line. Dylan Rice trying to track it down. Ball goes out of play for another Bell Vernon goal kick. With 4 minutes left here in the first half, still a 2-0 lead for Bell Vernon over Laurel Highlands. Brian Marilzak alongside Jerry Dupay, conference opener for both Laurel Highlands and Bell Vernon. Six teams in Section 3 AAA this season. Four will make the postseason. So a loss tonight, not devastating on either side. Trinity, Albert Gallatin, Ringgold, and Uniontown, the other Section 3 AAA conference foes. Mustangs will play Trinity next time out. The ball goes out of play on the far side. Brennan Morgan to fire it in. Into Hunter Martin. Martin down on the near side to Fort off of his head. On the back line, Timmy Mahalko and Jerry Frater both there for Laurel Highlands defensively. Saliga looking to center, went off of Fort and cleared there by Davis. Back up to Timmy Lucas, 2:51 left here in the first half. Lucas a little lob ahead, knocked down by Kolditz, and out of play here on the near side. Mustangs fired back in quickly. Again out. This time, what's the ruling here? Off of Bell Vernon announce. Now go back into Seaman. Seaman going cross field far side. Rapp plays it ahead. Dylan Rice will try to track it down. Dylan Rice tripped up there by Brennan Morgan, but the ruling is Morgan got the ball first, so no foul. Solid defense on the slide tackle there from Morgan. 2:10 left here in the first half. Mustangs fire it in. And knocked down again by Martin, played out on the far side. Todd Brown to take this throw in. Cleared again by the Leopards. Forward to Tyler Saliga. Saliga looking there for Logan Perez. Davis knocks it down. Hunter Martin plays it forward. Davis another touch. Chase forward here on the near side. Over to Brandon Fort. Off to Jackson Guess. Big collision there between Jared Davis and Tyler Saliga. Both players hop to their feet. Ball to play. Throw in here for Bell Vernon. Final 70 seconds of the first half. It's been an entertaining game so far, but the Leopards, the game's only two goals. R.L. Highland's about to make some halftime adjustments. They'd love to cut the lead in half here over the final minute. Seabart lost the ball. Mustangs, though, get back with Connor Rapp. Down to 40 seconds left. Leps on their back line. Brennan Morgan will send it all the way back to Tommy Rodriguez. Rodriguez with a left foot. Touched again down by Morgan. Love it a touch. Ford on the near side. Morgan again. Broken up by Seabart of Laurel Highlands. Up to Colby Davis. Love it a little pressure. Down to 13 seconds left. And now 10 seconds left. Jackson Guest there. And a 5 seconds left. Jackson Guest can't get open. Takes a little body bump there from Todd Brown, and that'll do it for the first half. Bell Vernon leading Laurel Highlands 2-0 here on the South Union Township Sports Network. We'll take a break and then recap the first half scoring for you right after this.
Chesler's Furniture at 601 Pittsburgh Street, Uniontown has been in business since 1950 and has a wide variety of furniture for all of your needs. At Chesler's, they have a wide assortment of living room recliners, kitchen sets, bedroom mattresses, and accessories that can decorate your home for years to come. Choose from many companies including Lazy Boy, Best, King Hickory, Amory, Lancer, Wildwood, Von Bassett, and White Dove. Chesler's also services what they sell. Stop into Chesler's Fine Furniture, Route 51 north of Uniontown, and see Kim, Christy, Ted, and Rich. They'll be happy to help you with all of your needs. Chesler's Furniture, where customers send their friends.
Tonight's soccer game is being brought to you in part by Dr. Michael Lemontowski and Surgical Associates, 10 Highland Park Drive here in Uniontown. They can be reached at 724-439-6340. Good luck to the area teams from Dr. Michael Lemontowski.
At what point did everything change? When did service get taken out of service industries? It's too bad, because people are busy these days, at life, at work, at play. When it comes to your hard-earned money, you want service, real service, from a person you know and a face you trust. At a bank where changing with the times doesn't mean leaving people behind. We're proud to be a part of your community. We're United Bank, at your service.
Back here at halftime, it's a 2-0 lead for the Bell Vernon Leopards over the Laurel Highlands Mustangs. The Leopards getting on the scoreboard first, just under 4 minutes into the game. Hunter Martin a goal at the 36:01 mark of the first half to give Bell Vernon a 1-0 lead. And then Bell Vernon's second goal scored by Markello Opodiakis at the 11:27 mark of the opening half to give Bell Vernon a 2-0 lead. It was a first half where Bell Vernon certainly controlled the time of possession. Laurel Highlands able to generate maybe a little bit more of an attack in the final 10 minutes of the first half, but Bell Vernon still really controlling things in the first half, and Laurel Highlands will have to make some halftime adjustments that they want to try to get back into this game. Reminder, if you're watching this game on Atlantic Broadband or Armstrong Cable, we'd like to let you know that South Union Township Sports Network games and programs are now available online. It's easy to find. Just log on to YouTube.com and search South Union Television or follow the South Union Township Sports Network on Facebook for program updates. It's Facebook.com/South Union TV. We also have to give a shout out to the Laurel Highlands girls soccer team. They're actually unbeaten in their last four games at the time of this taping. They're 3-1-2 overall, coming off a big 9-0 win over Uniontown, and we'll see them on the South Union Township Sports Network next week when they take on the Mount Pleasant Vikings. But here tonight at James Weir Stadium in Bell Vernon, it's the Bell Vernon Leopards leading the Laurel Highlands boys soccer team by a score of 2-0. We'll have second half match action on the way next here on the South Union Township Sports Network.
Southwestern Endoscopy Center is a state-licensed and Medicare-certified facility and emphasizes privacy, comfort, caring, and safety for colonoscopies and upper GI endoscopies. Painless procedures are done with twilight sedation given by a board-certified anesthesiologist. The center accepts most insurance plans and is staffed by Drs. Ruthart, Calabrese, Stokes, and Ballou. SWGI, specialists in digestive health.
Good luck to the Mustangs from the South Union Township Supervisors, Rick Vernon, Jason Scott, and Robert Schiffbauer.
Ready for second half match action, 2-0. Bell Vernon leading Laurel Highlands here on the South Union Township Sports Network. Hunter Martin and Markello Podiakis, the two first half goals for the Leopards. Laurel Highlands will now have to come out of the locker room on fire here to try to get back into this game. Down two as Timmy Lucas plays it back to Connor Rapp. As the Mustangs get the second half started with possession. Timmy Mahalko out of his own zone. Playing down the far side, Colby Davis trying to track it down there for Laurel Highlands. Sends it off, touched there by Lucas. Off to Seaman. And now Connor Rapp touches it back to Braden Steele. Steele on the near side. Margiela a touch. Steele again. And now Connor Rapp. Laurel Highlands hasn't found much room out there in the Bell Vernon zone throughout the course of the evening. As Rapp goes cross field on the far side. Mahalko plays it high. Eli Mitchell able to track it down and keep it in play. Here's Eli Mitchell far side. Mitchell on the cross, goes through. Colby Davis is there. Davis plays it off to his left, top of the box. Timmy Lucas headed back out there by the Leopards. Played back on by Rapp, deflected out in front, and played back to center by Bell Vernon. Leopards defense staying solid tonight. Tyler Saliga on the far side. Saliga trying to get around Timmy Mahalko, and off Mahalko and out. And Saliga will leave it back there for Aaron Brown to fire it in. Brown into Jackson Guess. Now Brown again. He'll go cross field near side. Over to Brennan Morgan, one of the Leopards' captains. Morgan's fighting off Timmy Lucas. Playing it back to Jarrett Guess. Guess chips it back down through Podiakis. Loose out in front here to Saliga. Saliga in open space. Saliga looking to cross. Broken up there by Laurel Highlands' Jared Davis. Davis will try to race back here for the Mustangs. Leopards keep possession again. It'll touch there from Mark Lovett. Knocked down by the Mustangs. Jared Davis goes low. Played back out by Bell Vernon. Back to Davis again. Davis trying to stay on it, but the Leps win possession again to Saliga. Forward to Markello Podiakis. Podiakis was won off the ball there by Laurel Highlands defensively. Braden Steele doing a nice job there to break it up, and now Laurel Highlands from their own zone will try to lead the attack back up through the midfield. Connor Rapp forward again to Timmy Lucas. Lucas in traffic. Leps flip it back on the far side over to Dylan Seaman. Off to Mahalko. Looking for Seaman again. Intercepted there by Jackson Guess. And here's Saliga. Tyler Saliga forward to Markello Podiakis. Podiakis trying to get around Jared Davis. Again, going back to the Mustang keeper, Jacob Campbell. Campbell plays it off to Braden Steele here on the near side. Steele touched by Margiela. Back to Steele. on the give and go. It's off of Laurel Highlands and out. Brendan Morgan back into Hunter Martin. Touchdown by Timmy Lucas, looking for Connor Rapp. Again, never gotten Rapp's direction. Morgan on the breakup. Reset to Hunter Martin and cleared by Jared Guess. Forward to Opodiakis. Markello Opodiakis. Back to Brendan Morgan. And off of Bell Vernon and out. That one going off of Evan Brown. We're 4 minutes into the second half. Still 2-0 Bell Vernon over Laurel Highlands. Margiela a touch there. Off to Connor Rapp. Rapp a little chip. Margiela in open space. Margiela a little collision there. And Margiela getting a little dinged. And a leopard down as well. Injury timeout also down there for Bell Vernon. Number 12, Jared Guess. So they'll bring out the trainer here for Guess. We'll take a quick timeout on the South Union Township Sports Network.
Tonight's soccer game is being brought to you in part by Dr. Michael Lemontowski and Surgical Associates, 10 Highland Park Drive here in Uniontown. They can be reached at 724-439-6340. Good luck to the area teams from Dr. Michael Lemontowski.
.35-57 left here in the second half. Jared Guess checking out of the game, walking off the field under his own power. Cameron Guess checking into the game for the Leopards. Brendan Morgan will trigger it in here for Bell Vernon. Now the ruling is Laurel Highlands ball. So Brendan Morgan will give way to Laurel Highlands' Dom Margiela. And Margiela will bounce it into Timmy Lucas. Again, not much open space out there for the Mustangs in the Bell Vernon zone. Leopards fire it out. Margiela will try to track down the loose ball. He does. Plays it back in here on the near side. Goes through Todd Brown. And the Leps pick it back up again. Here's Markello Opodiakis. Opodiakis with two Mustangs around him gets tripped up. And a foul called here on Laurel Highlands. Knocking down Opodiakis. No card issued. But a free kick here for the Leps. Cameron Guess to take the free kick. And the freshman has a huge leg. He'll chip it here, top of the box. Laurel Highlands trying to clear here on the near side of Margiela. Laurel Highlands able to pick up the loose ball. Rap off to Margiela, who's unable to track it down here on the near side. Brendan Morgan fires it in on the back line of Cameron Guess. He'll go cross field far side. And on the chase, Mark Lovett keeping it in play in front of the far touchline. Seaman a touch for Laurel Highlands, battling there with Aaron Brown for Bell Vernon. Brown wins the ball. Back to Lovett, forward there to Jackson Guess before Connor Rapp intercepts for Laurel Highlands. Now Dylan Seaman. Seaman going ahead, looking for Margiela, never got his way. Evan Brown on the breakup, plays it back to the keeper Rodriguez. And Tommy Rodriguez low on the near side. Up again to Evan Brown, Mustangs on the breakup, Timmy Lucas. And the shot from about 35 yards out goes wide on the far side. Those have been really the only shot attempts the Mustangs have had from, well, outside the box tonight. The Leopards' defense has been stellar. This is actually the first meeting between these two schools in over 2 years. Last meeting, August the 31st of 2014. A 2-1 win for Laurel Highlands over Bell Vernon. The last Leopards win over the Mustangs, you have to go back to September the 2nd of 2012, a 3-1 win for the Leopards over the Laurel Highlands Mustangs, and that was part of a magical season for the Bell Vernon Leopards, and saw the Leps advance to the state playoffs, winning the WPIL third place game after losing in the WPIL semifinals to Mars. They were eliminated by Harbor Creek in the state playoffs. And they feel this squad has an opportunity maybe to make another run, but Laurel Highlands trying to cut the Belle Vernon lead in half here. On the near side, Margello looking on the cross, knocked down by Rodriguez. And the Leps able to clear it back to Jackson Guest. That might have been the best scoring opportunity Laurel Highlands has had all night. Todd Brown in traffic, threw an elbow, and that should be a yellow card. Brown, an obvious elbow thrown there. And be lucky if a card's not shown. They'll just rule this a foul on Belle Vernon, so then the Mustangs really catching a break there. Now Podiakis will try to break out of his own zone again for the Leopards. Moves to Margella here on the near side. Deflected back by Belle Vernon. Picked up by Jackson Guest. Forward to Markello Podiakis. Podiakis now will have to try to get around Jared Davis. He'll play it off to his right. Dancing there is Evan Brown. Brown resets on the far side to Aaron Brown. Aaron Brown's shot might have been deflected on the far side. Went off of Belle Vernon's Tyler Saliga before it went out, so it will be Laurel Highlands' goal kick. If you go back to the last free kick Laurel Highlands had on the other side, you have to wonder what precipitated that elbow thrown by Brown. And obviously the referee saw something there, and that's why the free kick was issued in the Laurel Highlands direction instead of an elbow call there on Brown. Now Laurel Highlands showing a little more fight here in the second half. Still a lot of time left in this match. 31-04 left here in the second half. Laurel Highlands still down two. Seaman off to Connor Rapp. Broken up again by the Leopards. Jackson Guess on the far side. Over to Aaron Brown. Sent on the back line. Forward there by Brennan Morgan. Off to Evan Brown. Look out. Here's Evan Brown in open space. Slide tackle there from Jared Davis. Risky play there inside the box. But Davis doing a nice job there on the slide tackle to get ball first. If you go in like that and you get man before the ball, you're looking at a penalty kick from 12 yards out on the other side. This one chipped back to Rodriguez with Colby Davis bearing down. And Rodriguez able to scoop it up. He can afford to waste a little time right now with Belle Vernon leading by two. Rodriguez on the high lob back to center. Rapp looking for the header. Played, though, by Jackson Guess. Colditz a touch. Low looking for a Podiakis. Will go through and back to the keeper, Campbell. Mentioned Campbell, a pair of clean sheets already on the season. Laurel Highlands with shutout wins over Bentworth and McKeesport, 4-0 over the Bearcats, 9-0 over the Tigers. Laurel Highlands also a 9-1 win over Brownsville. Laurel Highlands' lone loss coming against Thomas Jefferson on the road last week, losing 3-0, and Laurel Highlands drawing Elizabeth Forward last time out at 2-2. And this free kick going into the box, whistled down, was offsides. And a free kick here for Laurel Highlands. Keeper Campbell will put it down. Looked to send it down on the far side to Colby Davis. Never got his way. There's Aaron Brown breaking back. Aaron Brown with a head of steam going through Mustangs. His shot finally blocked there by Jared Davis, who just sends it out of bounds on the far side. Aaron Brown looking, making a couple of Mustangs look invisible out there. Dancing through the Mustang defense. Throw in to be taken here by Cameron Guess. Watch for him to fire this into the box in the long throw. Guess about a 10-yard run up here. Low line drive. Knocked down by Eli Mitchell. Guess gets it back. Guess circles top of the box, broken up by Dylan Seaman. Mustangs now with numbers coming back. And Eli Mitchell went flying there for Laurel Highlands. Guess picks it back up on the Bell Vernon side. That was Jackson back to Cameron Guess. Now Aaron Brown looking for the cross. Brown into the corner. Crosses out in front, ball loose. So Podiakas picks it up. He'll touch it back and then get it back. And his shot attempt goes wide on the far side. Goal kick here for Laurel Highlands. Brennan Morgan showing nice support on the attack for the Leopards as well. One of the Bell Vernon co-captains coming up and giving Markello Podiakas assistance on the play. We're down to 27-15 left here in the second half. Mustangs still down 2-0. No goals have been scored here in the second half. The two Bell Vernon goals coming from Hunter Martin and Markello Podiakas. Martin scoring 3 minutes and 59 seconds in. And the Podiakas goal coming at the 11:27 mark of the first half. Alex McLay playing it back to Braden Steele there on the Laurel Highlands side. McLay another touch. Pushed off the ball there by Jackson Guess. Ruled a foul there on Jackson. Free kick for Laurel Highlands to be put down here by Braden Steele. Mustang junior defender. Hand in the air. Line drive forward. Knocked down by Lucas. Touched over to Rapp. But again, the Leopards' defense too strong. Four to Markello Podiakas again trying to get a run around Davis. Jared Davis, though, saw it on the back line. Mustangs get support there from Todd Brown. Another scrum for it. Might have been a handball not called there on Davis. Mustangs keep it alive. Seaman trying to spin back. Assistance there from Rapp. Pressure from Jackson Guess and Markello Podiakas on the Bell Vernon side as well. Finally, Lucas. Just send it down. Laurel Highlands on the attack. Colby Davis, was he tripped up? Davis is going to stay with it. Low shot. Leopards pick it up. Ball not out. And the ball out of play will stay with Laurel Highlands. You wonder there for a moment if the advantage was just played, but no foul ever whistled down after Bell Vernon got possession. We play on. But Davis finally getting free behind the pack. McLay on the throw-in, headed there by Davis. Scrum forward here on the near side. Rapp has it as his jersey grabbed from behind. That has to be a foul there on Jared Guess. And Laurel Highlands now with a free kick coming up here from about 25 yards out. They'll send the wall back 10 yards. And finally, Laurel Highlands with a nice opportunity here in the Leopard zone, the final 25 minutes of regulation. Rapp to take the free kick. Rapp will just go right at goal and just went high. Nice opportunity from Rapp. Went over the wall, but also went over the crossbar and over the head of Tommy Rodriguez. Had a play for a Bell Vernon goal kick. It'll be Jared Guess to take this goal kick for the Leopards. Up to Evan Brown. Mustangs knock it down. Here's McLay near side. Touched by Rapp. Off the body there of Brennan Morgan. Up to a Podiakas again. On the far side, Aaron Brown. Brown stops in the corner, tries to work it down the far line. Mustangs knock it out. This will be a Leopards corner kick. Laurel Highlands soccer program, plenty of success over the last 6 to 7 years. In fact, last year was the first time since 2011 that Laurel Highlands did not make the playoffs, going 7-8-3. the standings from last year were in 2016. Laurel Highlands would get in. Last year, only three teams taken. This year, four get in. There's a shot going way high off the corner from Hunter Martin. Laurel Highlands tied for fourth place in the conference last year with Waynesburg. The three playoff qualifiers out of then Section 6 in AA, Ringgold, McGuffey, and Trinity. Bel Vernon playing the 2015 season in Section 3 AA, finished in third place behind South Park and Thomas Jefferson. All three teams, of course, advancing to the WPIO playoffs, but the Leopards' playoff run short-lived. They lost in the first round to Ringgold by a score of 2-0. McLay here for Laurel Highlands, lobbing it high. Lucas with a little pressure out in front of the Mustangs. Get their opening goal of the game. That might even be an own goal off of Rodriguez and in. The Laurel Highlands will take it any way they can get it. I think it was actually Rodriguez that knocked it in. Own goal at the 22-18 mark of the second half. And the Mustangs have cut the Bel Vernon lead in half to 2-1. We're back in a moment here on the South Union Township Sports Network. Back here on the South Union Township Sports Network. I think you have to credit that an own goal off of Rodriguez and in. The Mustangs had Timmy Lucas tracking down out in front, but it was actually Rodriguez that knocked it into the back of his own nets. We'll rule it an own goal off of Rodriguez. 22 minutes left in this match. Laurel Highlands right back in it, down 2-1. Ball sent in here to steal. And Jackson Guess will pick it up. And Guess playing it forward. Leopards trying to get the lead back to two. Played out, though, by Timmy Mahalko. And reset here at center by Jackson Guess. On the back line to Jared Guess. Go cross field here on the near side to Brennan Morgan. Morgan with a little pressure there from McLay. Will send it ahead to Evan Brown. Knocked down by Braden Steele. Now that ball was out. We're going to play on. Davis goes forward again, looking there for Lucas. Chipped at center by Martin. Up to Jackson Guess. Now Logan Perez will look to track it down. Mahalko pressuring there for Laurel Highlands. Played back on the far side to Aaron Brown, and Brown loses it. Mustangs play it back up, looking for Colby Davis. Goes through Davis, has a little support there from Timmy Lucas, but cleared back by Jared Guess of Bel Vernon. Mustangs, though, regain to the midfield. Seaman a little touch off to Eli Mitchell. Mitchell from 40 out. A little miscommunication there with Connor Rapp. Mustangs, though, keep possession with Todd Brown. Off to Braden Steele here on the near side. Steele forward to Rapp, looking again for Steele. Cleared out by Brennan Morgan, and now a little collision here at midfield between Logan Perez of Bel Vernon and Todd Brown of Laurel Highlands. The foul going on Perez. Free kick here for the Mustangs. Davis goes quickly into the box. Jarrett looking for Colby, comes back out to Lucas. His shot blocked down, and the Leopards clear it out here on the near side, but Laurel Highlands will keep possession off of Evan Brown and out. Connor Rapp plays it right back to Evan Brown, and now Markello Podiakis on the attack for Bel Vernon. Two on three for the Leps of Podiakis. Lost it for a moment, regained, shot on goal, and in another athletic goal for Markello Podiakis. And you go back to what set that up. An errant throw-in from Rapp of Podiakis. Scoring on the other side, lead back up to two for Bel Vernon at 3-1. We'll take a break, 19:41 left in regulation here on the South Union Township Sports Network. 19-41 left here in the second half. Markello Podiakis with a brace tonight. Two goals for the Leps. Give him a lot of credit there. First on the attack, then fighting off Jared Davis. And on the second attempt, sending it past Jacob Campbell to regain a little cushion on the Bell Vernon side. A lead at 3-1. And after Laurel Highland scored on the own goal off of Tommy Rodriguez and in. And now you have 19 minutes left. We're back where we started the second half with Laurel Highlands down two. Timmy Mahalko on the far side sends it out. Leopards go quick. Laurel Highlands might be sleeping on the defense. A little run in there from Tyler Saliga. Laurel Highlands getting lucky defensively there. Saliga lost control of that one. And Campbell plays it back to center. Forward to Colby Davis. Good job to knock it down. Here's Evan Brown. Brown off to his left. Trying to fight off Braden Steele. Brown to his right. Back to a Podiakis. He's out there looking for the HT. Seaman breaking that attack up for Laurel Highlands. I mean, look at these, the Podiakis brothers. Markello has the two goals tonight, only a sophomore. We mentioned his brother Nico, only a freshman. And you look at the athletic prowess of Markello, what we've seen so far tonight. You have to think he's going to have a bright future here at Bell Vernon. Our Highlands, though, still on the fight and still on the attack in this conference opener, down two. Still plenty of time left, 17:44 left here in the second half. Laurel Highlands trying to keep the pressure up, and there's a shot on the far side going wide from Dylan Seaman. It'll be a Bell Vernon goal kick. Brandon Ford back into the game on the Bell Vernon side. Evan Brown checking out. Josh Martin also checking in. A pair of substitutions here for the Leps. I mentioned next up for Laurel Highlands, the host Trinity, before traveling to Ringgold. On the Bell Vernon side, they'll head to Fayette County and take on Uniontown in their next game and play a road game at Trinity. It's 3-1, Leps over the Mustangs. I think a push is going to be called there on Connor Rapp. Free kick for Bell Vernon from about 31 yards out. Jared Guess will take it. Lead at two. Guess goes quickly. Opodiakis near post. Goes wide on the header. So again, Bell Vernon going quickly, trying to get Laurel Highlands napping out there. And Campbell takes the goal kick. Touch back by Kolditz. Seaman there, unable to make much happen for the Mustangs as it goes out on the far side. Our Highlands last in the playoffs in 2014, defeated Southmoreland in the first round before losing to South Park in the second round. Here's a Podiakis, some help with Saliga, push forward, and a Podiakis there again. Podiakis into the box. Knocked down. Laurel Highlands' Jarrett Davis. Leps stay with it. Now a whistle. Having offsides there on Bell Vernon. Free kick for Laurel Highlands. Mentioned Bell Vernon. Ranked in this week's boys soccer AAA top 10 at number 9. In fact, they're the only team in Laurel Highlands Conference ranked in the top 10. Mars, no surprise, at number 1. Thomas Jefferson, who has a win over Laurel Highlands, at number 2. Moon at 3. Montour at 4. And Char Valley at number 5. Here's Lucas trying to come forward. Looking there for Jared Davis. Never got his way. Back to Seaman, who draws the double team off to Rapp again. Connor Rapp. Looking for Lucas. Leps on the back line. Chip. Josh Martin trying to track it down. A little pressure there from Braden Steele. Mia Bell Vernon throwing. Mustangs motioning to Braden Steele, hey, make sure you get back. Laurel Highlands down two. Sending Steele up a little bit on the near side. And Todd Brown and Eli Mitchell a little bit up on the far side, really only leaving Timmy Mahalko and Jarrett Davis back defensively. Laurel Highlands having to take more chances here, down two. Here's Josh Martin straddling the near line to keep it alive. Braden Steele, though, solid defense for Laurel Highlands. He'll go low, forward looking for Rapp. Again, knocked down on the left side. Brennan Morgan forward up to Tyler Saliga, and the play whistled down. This might be a penalty kick here for Bell Vernon. If a foul is whistled inside the box, we had this occur the other night. If a foul's inside the box, it has to be a penalty kick, not a free kick with a wall. This would be an incorrect application of the rules if a free kick where they're going to allow Laurel Highlands to set up a wall defensively is utilized. If a foul's inside the box, it should be a penalty kick from 12 yards with no wall being allowed to be set up defensively. This is unbelievable. They're going to let this continue from that position, and it's going to be sent high. If a foul's inside the box, it should have been a penalty kick. Wow. We saw that corrected the other night, but not corrected here tonight. Laurel Highlands catches a break. 12:45 left here in the second half. Laurel Highlands still down two. Here's a Podiakis again. Back to Martin. Martin top of the box to Nico Opodiakis. You've both Opodiakis out there right now, Markello and Nico. It's Markello with it right now. Markello off to his right, shot on goal, and saved there by Jacob Campbell. Had brother Nico trying to screen out in front. Mustangs again played back to center. Now Vernon's still on it. Steele trying to clear. Colby Davis, a little collision there on the Laurel Highlands side with Evan Brown. Scrum fort. Picked up by Nico Opodiakis. Touchdown by Saliga. And circled back on the near side on the back line of Brennan Morgan. Morgan. Up to Markello Opodiakis, and now Morgan again. Morgan trying to work his way around Alex McLay. Off of McLay and out. 11:15 left here in regulation. Leopards the ball, up two. Martin, a little pressure there on McLay. Again played back to center. Headed along by Jared Guess, Nico Opodiakis, and Tyler Saliga in the vicinity on the Bell Vernon side. Sending it free to Brandon Fort. Fort double-teamed. Mustangs finally win the ball. Dylan Seaman there. Sent ahead to Eli Mitchell. And Colby Davis unable to track it down before the ball was knocked out of play off of Bell Vernon and out. So Laurel Highlands trying to set something up here. Quick throw into Colby Davis. Headed back by Brennan Morgan. Again, out of bounds off of Bell Vernon and out. Eli Mitchell will take this throw in. Mitchell fires back into Timmy Lucas. Mustangs keep possession. Long shot from 25 yards. Well off the mark. As we approach 10 minutes remaining in regulation, the lead still at 2 for the Bell Vernon Leopards over the Laurel Highlands Mustangs. We were talking about the boys soccer top 10. We give you the top 5. Ambridge at number 6, South Fayette at 7, Greensburg-Salem at 8, Mentioned the Leps at 9 and the Gateway Gators in AAA this year in the four classification system for boys soccer. At number 10, now we'll see the Leps take a little more time here in between plays. Going to run this clock down, leading by 2, a 3-1. Dawson Quinto into the game. We'll send this ahead to Markello Podiakis. Podiakis won off the ball there by Braden Steele, but a Podiakis will get it back. Markello Podiakis off to Hunter Martin. Martin scored the opening goal tonight. Touch there from Peyton Kolditz. Off to Aaron Brown. Brown trying to dance around Eli Mitchell. Ball last touch by Bell Vernon going out. Be a goal kick here for Laurel Highlands. Mustangs running out of time. Down to 8:48 left here in the second half. Brian Morozak alongside Jerry Dupe. Nice to have you along with us here on the South Union Township Sports Network for boys soccer action. Mustangs in a tight one here tonight, down 2. Marl Highlands entering play 3-1-1. We mentioned this, the conference opener for both teams. Bell Vernon at 2-1. Leps coming off a 10-6 season a year ago. Jumped on Laurel Highlands early. Mustangs got back to within 2-1 after they put some pressure on Tommy Rodriguez, and the ball went off the Leopards keeper and in for an own goal. Now Markello Podiakis has been the difference on the Leopards' side. A pair of goals, including an answer back after the own goal. With the Leps back up 2, we have an injury. Leopards player down in front of their bench. It's number 11, Brennan Morgan. So with Morgan down, we'll take a quick timeout here on the South Union Township Sports Network.
At what point did everything change? When did service get taken out of service industries? It's too bad, because people are busy these days, at life, at work, at play. When it comes to your hard-earned money, you want service, real service, from a person you know and a face you trust. At a bank where changing with the times doesn't mean leaving people behind. We're proud to be a part of your community. We're United Bank, at your service.
Back here on the South Union Township Sports Network, Brennan Morgan was the Leopard that was down. He's now being attended to on the bench. A little hydration break here on both sides. Clock stops, 7:46. Left in regulation. And our crew of Jim Pride and Jan Johnston getting together here. Jackson Guess back in on the Leopard side. Hunter Cardillo also into the game tonight on the Bell Vernon side. The Laurel Highlands free kick from the edge of their own zone. Braden Steele to take it. We'll roll the clock now. 7:46 left here in the second half as Steele sends it down the field. Top of the box, a little contact. Davis pushed off the ball, trying to stay with it. Was that a handball? Was it inside the box? I think just outside the box for about 19 yards out. So they'll be allowed to set up the wall here. And Laurel Highlands an opportunity to get back to within one on the free kick from 19 yards out. You have both Dylan Seaman and Connor Rapp there. We'll see who takes it. Also Timmy Lucas positioned behind Seaman. Rapp has his hand in the air. Seaman makes the run up. It'll be Lucas who will fire. And what a save from Rodriguez. That one off the crossbar on the rebound from Todd Brown. Hey, Rodriguez standing tall. Laurel Highlands sending one off of Rodriguez. And the second from Brown off the crossbar. And we stay at 3-1. Rodriguez has been stellar in goal tonight. Yielding just the one goal that he actually sent in after a little defensive confusion. Out of the left at the 22-18 mark of the second half. Other than that, he's been picture perfect. Goal kick here for Laurel Highlands. The Mustangs really running out of time now. Down to 6:05 left here in the second half. Campbell to take it. Plays it back to center. Lucas goes high. McLay on the run along with Colby Davis. That one scooped by Tommy Rodriguez again. Rodriguez back to center. Rodriguez looks like a cool customer out there too. Headband on. Neon jersey. Looks very comfortable in goal for the Belle Vernon Leopards. Wrap a little header. McLay plays hacky sack with it, now heads it back. Wrap there, off to his left, and Lucas sends it high and off the net. On a 5:02 left here in the second half. Mustangs down two, in danger of dropping their conference opener. The conference schedule tough for Laurel Highlands early on this week. Games, of course, at Belle Vernon here today, home against Trinity. Trinity has traditionally been a pretty strong soccer program over the last couple of years. Lucas on that run-up, well defended again by the Lemps. Then at Ringgold. The conference schedule getting a little bit easier next week. Games at least the Mustangs should be favored in against Albert Gallatin and Uniontown. These two teams will meet for a second time this season at Laurel Highlands on September the 27th. There's Connor Rapp off to his left to Lucas. Low shot goes wide. And he could conceivably see Laurel Highlands falling into an early hole. But essentially, with only six teams in the conference, Laurel Highlands can get wins next week over Albert Gallatin and Uniontown and still be sitting pretty as far as qualifying for the WPIL playoffs. But obviously, you want to try to finish as high in the conference as you can to improve your playoff seeding. And Laurel Highlands has shown they can play with Belle Vernon here today. You had some nice athletic efforts out of players like Markello Podiakis. They've really been the difference so far in this contest. Tyler Saliga on the far side crosses out in front, and that one goes wide. A goal kick for Laurel Highlands. With 3:10 left. And we mentioned earlier, worth mentioning again, if you're watching on Atlantic Broadband or Armstrong Cable, all of our South Union Township sports broadcasts also available on YouTube. We actually just went past our one-year anniversary mark of the games being available online. Just search South Union Television on YouTube or follow the South Union Township Sports Network on Facebook for program updates, facebook.com/SouthUnionTV. Very easy to find. There's Steele upending Matt Wobrak. Wobrak just entering the game. I think it's chucked down there by Steele. So Belle Vernon will, unless something crazy happens here in the final couple of minutes, pick up their first win over Laurel Highlands since 2012. As Jared Guest sends it top of the box, played back to Matt Wobrak. And in the scrum, Steele will find the loose ball here for Laurel Highlands. Braden Steele on his horse. Mustang's not giving up yet. Lucas down to Alex McAlay. Defended by Hunter Cardillo. Ball goes out of bounds off of Belle Vernon and out. 1:53 left. Lucas fires it into the box. Headed out by Martin. Seaman a touchback to Timmy Mahalko. Played low. Seaman chases it down, 35 outs. Down to 90 seconds left in the game. Seaman from 30, shot on goal. One hops into Tommy Rodriguez. Now Rodriguez on the long boot after a dribble. Down to Logan Perez. Pressured from behind by Eli Mitchell. Eli's brother, Zach, a heck of a player here. Laurel Highlands as well, graduated last year. Now to 60 seconds left. Fun one, though, to watch tonight at James Weir Stadium on the Gold Turf. Timmy Mahalko coming forward. Broken up by Wobrak. Touchdown by Evan Brown. Brown on the run, up looking for a late goal for the Mustangs. Brown loose. Denied by Campbell. 40 seconds left. Campbell, low rollout here on the near side to Connor Rapp. Rapp down the near touchline, defended there by Chris McCullough. Off to his left to Seaman, 30 seconds left. Mustangs still going strong, down to Alex McLay offsides. McLay getting behind Hunter Cardillo with 18 seconds left. Good shoulder or two behind him. We're down to the final 10 seconds. Leps can just boot it down the field, and that'll do it. Off of a pair of goals from Markello Podiakis and a Hunter Martin goal, the Belle Vernon Leopards. A 3-1 win over the Laurel Highlands Mustangs. The Mustangs own goal tonight, an own goal off of Tommy Rodriguez. The Laurel Highlands drops their conference opener. They fall to 3-2-1 overall, 0-1 in the conference. Belle Vernon improves to 3-1 overall and 1-0 in the conference with the win. Tonight's game was brought to you as a joint cooperative venture featuring Township Supervisors Bob Schiffbauer, Rick Vernon, and Jason Scott, Atlantic Broadband, Armstrong Cable, and our friends at CUTV, including Gary Smith and his staff. I'm Brian Morozak with Jerry Dupay. This has been a South Union Township Sports Network presentation. Again, your final score, Belle Vernon 3 and Laurel Highlands 1. That's all, everybody.